is Jonas Kornecker from the University of Leon. I'm here to present a project that is not so ambitious and not so good funded, such as this we have been discussing. It's a more local project, but it's focusing a topic that is quite cool for some instances, such as Horizon 2020 and another proposals, but such as digital aging and older people. Okay. So what we are going to describe here is a mobile apps repository thought specifically for older people and taking into account their specific necessities. Here we have the outline we are going to follow, introduction, the context of the project, how we have carried out the development of the project, and some conclusions. So introduction, we can say that if we think about how people is going older, we can see that taking into account World Health Organization from 1980 till 2050, the number of older people in the world is going to double, which is something very very important and that we should consider, because older people has specific necessities, they use the technology, they interact with others, so we have to take into account how they interact with their peers and with other people. Other people don't use the technology in the same way as us. Sometimes they can be considered as, not sometimes, I think right now they can be considered as digital immigrants. Okay, as so we should try to integrate them with other people that use technology, trying to reduce a digital gap that exists. For them, technology should be inclusive and not exclusive. Okay, and but right now they are afraid because technology is not adapted to their needs. It's not adapted to some specific, very specific necessities, their aims. So I think it's an interesting question to think about how are they using the technology and which with aims. Well, as I have said, Horizon 2020 has a specific goal that is digital aging. I think that these kind of projects are in focus. This project specifically is funded by Cátedra Telefónica, in this case from the University of Leon, that is researching about DICS and digital aging. If we think about the technology, we are using social networks, we are using mobile apps, we are using the internet, we are using tools in the cloud. Okay. But what are older people using? Older people use these kind of tools, yes, not all people, but most of them, but they use in other way. For instance, I think that if you look for studies about this, you can find out that older people should be considered from 60 and older, okay? Older people use technologies such as the email, such as mobile phones, but they use in a different way. For instance, most of older people have a mobile phone. Okay, in fact, recent studies said that 90% of older people. But how do they use this kind of devices? They use this kind of devices only for calling, for phoning, only to send SMS, but not used to use it for using the internet. Well, as people is going older, now we have a considerable set of people that is using the mobile phones with other purposes, such as the use of apps and things like that. But they have another worries that are not those that we are considering. Taking this into account, and taking into account that we are finding this kind of things, that people is being involved, are being being linked to technology all day, and other people also, we have to think if some of these technologies could be adapted to them. Okay, and one of the technologies that is most used nowadays are mobile phones and mobile devices. Here we have, a description of how mobile cellular subscriptions has grown from 2005. And in fact, right now in developed countries, at least I think the number is 1 point, I don't know how much of mobile devices per person. So all person has one or more mobile devices. Taking in Silicon, what we have tried to define is a repository with apps for other people and also taking into account the specific necessities. Okay? And in order to do this, we have to first ask us about the usability of these mobile devices. Okay? How to measure the usability? This is difficult. This is difficult because usability is not the same for me and for other person. And other people has specific, very specific necessities and very specific features. They have normally problems with their side, touching. They don't touch the screen in the same way as us. So we have to take that into account. For other, an example, they need more time to complete tasks with mobile devices. They have problems such as the size of the screen, the size of the menus, and input interfaces, drag and drop, the size of the target is the point in which you are going to touch, the intended touch, and other issues such as the size of characters, good sound quality, as people get older, they should have problems with their ears, and I think things like this should be taken into account. The problem is that there are a lot of work in this way, but there is not the standards. You should look in the literature and find out get those criteria that you think that are more that fits more with this kind of necessities. The necessities of all people. Here we have some of the features such as memory aids, visual aids, haptic aids. Minimize errors, provides things to minimize the probability of error. Safety features, to take into account if they have failed. In fact, in Catalina Telefonica, there is a project that is specifically to detect if older people fell down to the floor. Large font size, simple menu structures, big buttons, neutral colors. When you define a mobile app, you are not taking this things into account always. Try to reduce redundance, representing the elements in the same way in the different tools, in the different apps. In fact, if you look for mobile apps, you can see that some people use a kind of icon for the internet, other things, so that's to confuse them. And also avoid analysis when you are using applications in other languages. Okay? That is also something very common. We also should ask us about their specific needs. That is, why are they using this kind of devices, and with which purpose? Okay, and we have looked for classification. There are several. Here is one that try to put together some of the features. For example, they classify the tools in. They want to have tools about health, wellness, and home care, safety, security, and privacy, mobility information, chore, religion, and spirituality, social interaction, etc. And also, looking in the literature, we have found that there is no specific repositories with apps for this kind of persons. In fact, you can pick your phones. I'm looking the App Store or Google Play, looking for specific tools for older people, and there is not too much. You can look for tools for health, and there are a lot of tools. But in this case, it's more limited, so it's difficult. And the idea is to provide them a point in which they can look for tools that really are interesting for them and are adapted to their necessities. So in this case, we find a project that has beginning with an evaluation of the state of the art. Later on, study the most popular apps and functionalities that should be included in a mobile device. We have defined the classification criteria, and we are trying to evaluate it. It's not completely validated. We have defined an app repository, and we are classifying tools and introducing tools now. Functionalities that has this repository: a system to classify the tools, a system to evaluate the tools. Our idea is that the older people can decide what tools are the best for them and take into account their opinion. Okay. Also, visualization, find a repository that takes also into account the features of this kind of persons. So we should be careful with this. We have to find a visualization, proper visualization for all of them. Web and mobile adaptive use, because when you download an app, it's generally from your device and not from the web. And also an advanced search and recommender that, depending on the profile of the other people that is connected to the repository, suggests him or her some different tools. And also, well, as any repository, you need a user content management and a download management in order to download these kind of apps. Here is the structure. We have to use Drupal CMS in order to define this, to develop this repository, because it's a very popular CMS and it could be easily used in functionalities related to the store of apps and things like that. Here we have the classification system, an advanced search and recommender, and a content manager. All these elements are wrapped with an interface, so there is something transparent for the user, are only functional. Okay. And here we have some of the questions we've asked as a criteria to classify tools. For example, taking into account visual aids, you can ask, can you change the text size using the zoom or other methods? The size font, in case of the audio, can you adjust the sound of the application? In case of the app, is it easy to use, is it easy to touch? We have defined an scale, and we have been classifying this kind of. Here you have the repositories. This is not very, I don't know, the look and feel is not most cool, but it's best adapted to the necessities of all. Here we have the advanced researcher, and here we can see the CMS and the management system. As a conclusion, we should think that ICT is something necessary, but something necessary for all, not only for us, and we should take into account all kind of collective necessities. Technology should be inclusive. If we are defining a technology that is not inclusive with all persons, we are not defining that technology for all. We are trying to separate group of people. And we should take into account other people's necessities and satisfy them. And also, it is we have tried to define a scalable and efficient solution that could be applied in other kind of projects. Okay? And that's all.